With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone, let's start the question. The question says that which of the following statement is false, right? Here we have been given four options, so we have to find out the false or the incorrect statement out of the following, right? So let's start with option number one. In option number one, it says that about 25% of solar energy reaching the earth is absorbed by the earth's surface, right? Now we have to find whether this statement is correct or not. Well, this is an incorrect statement. Why so? Because we know that solar energy which comes from sun, right? So this solar energy, when it reaches the earth's surface, then about 70% of the solar energy is absorbed by the earth's surface, right? And the rest 30% of that solar energy, it is reflected by the earth's surface, right? Whereas in the given option, we have been given that about 25% of the solar energy is absorbed. No, this is incorrect. The correct value is that 70% of the solar energy is absorbed by the earth's surface. So option number one will be the incorrect or the false statement here, right? But we'll still discuss other options also. Now option number two says that the greenhouse gases trap some of the heat that is radiated back to the atmosphere, right? So this statement is correct because we know that the solar energy and the radiations coming from the sun, they are absorbed by the earth's surface and rest are reflected back. Now these radiations which are coming are trapped by the greenhouse gases, and we know that what are greenhouse gases. Let me mention some of the most abundant greenhouse gases which are present in the atmosphere. So these greenhouse gases like methane, CO2, nitrogen oxide like N2O, and even we have ozone, which is a greenhouse gas. So these greenhouse gases, to name few, they trap the heat which is present in the atmosphere, right, which is radiated back to the atmosphere. So this statement is also correct, that greenhouse gases trap the heat which is radiated back to the atmosphere. So option number two is correct here, right? Now moving on to option number three, it is given that natural greenhouse effect is essential for life because it maintains the temperature and make earth perfect for life. Now this statement is also true because it is important for the atmosphere to have these greenhouse gases. Now why? Because of the presence of these greenhouse gases, they are responsible for what? They are responsible for the greenhouse effect, right? And we know that in greenhouse effect, what happens is that these greenhouse gases, they absorb and they trap the heat of the earth's surface and they don't let these radiations get out of the atmosphere. So it rises the temperature of the earth's surface, right? It makes the earth atmosphere more heat absorbed in, right? So since more heat gets absorbed in the earth atmosphere and since the temperature of the earth atmosphere rises, because otherwise if these greenhouse gases were not present in the earth surface, then the temperature of the earth atmosphere would drop and earth would have become a cold planet. So life, we know that, only exists at a higher temperature, right? So if greenhouse gases wouldn't exist, then in that case, life to exist on earth would have become impossible. That is why option number three is also correct. Now moving on to the fourth option, we have, if the amount of CO2 present in the atmosphere crosses the delicate proportion of 0.03%, the natural greenhouse gas may get disturbed. Right, so for this we should know that CO2 molecules, right? CO2 is also a greenhouse gas, and these CO2 molecules, they trap heat, right? And they are also transparent to sunlight, but not to the heat radiation, right? So let me write down that CO2 is transparent to light, right? It is transparent to sunlight, and it also traps heat, these CO2 molecules, because we know that CO2 is what? CO2 is also a greenhouse gas, right? So if the amount of CO2, when it crosses the proportion of 0.03%, then the natural greenhouse balance gets disturbed, right? CO2 is one of the major contributor for global warming, right? So that is why it is important to have CO2 in our atmosphere, but not more than 0.03%, right? Because it would then affect the greenhouse effect, right? And it would affect the balance in the atmosphere. Beside CO2, we have other greenhouse gases like methane, also nitrous oxide, CFCs, ozones, etc. Right? So that means out of the following option, option number one is the false statement. So option number one will be our answer to the question. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.